Hello everyone, I am Rohit and welcome to my YouTube channel AI Era. So guys, in this particular video, I am going to explore another tool used for a data visualization by using Plotly and Couplings. The tool is known as a geographical plotting or a choropleth maps. By using these maps or by using these techniques such as choropleth maps or a geographical plotting, we can visualize our data set by using a various kind of maps such as a world maps or by using a particular country maps. So today we are going to see or we are going to use a COVID-19 data set and see a total positive patient among the world and which country are on the top of total positive patient. So without doing any delay, just jump into a Jupyter notebook. Before moving to our Jupyter notebook, I would like to tell you that I am created a video on machine learning, and here on my channel you can find out various videos such as predict wine quality using machine learning, also diabetes prediction using a machine learning, and also I am created a playlist on pandas, numpy and data visualization libraries. So believe me guys, if you want to learn data science or in future if you want to become a data scientist, then starting with this basic library is give you essential confidence. So it's my humble request to you to please access those library and do subscribe my YouTube channel and press this bell icon and never miss on any update. So as I told you earlier, today we are going to create a geographical plotting or map a geographical plot. So therefore we require a dataset. So simply we download our dataset from a Kaggle website. Here a Kaggle website, this guy, that is Devakumar KP, has provided a dataset, a COVID-19 dataset. In that COVID-19 dataset, we particularly download this worldometer data.csv. This data contains country, region, confirmed death and total 15 features. So we go into deep how my dataset look like into a Jupyter notebook. Don't worry guys, for your reference, the link Kaggle link is provided in the description, so you can download this data for your reference or for your practice session. So just jump into a Jupyter notebook and start the coding. So guys, here I am in my Jupyter notebook. So working with Plotly and Couplings, so first I have to import this Plotly and Couplings, both the library, by using a pip command. And how to import it or how to download this command or how to download this particular library such as Plotly and Couplings using a pip command, that I can shown in my previous video, and the link of previous video is below in description. To import a Plotly library, I have to simply write import Plotly as py. To execute this cell, I have to press and shift enter. Next, from plotly.offline, I have to import some necessary tool such as download underscore plotly.js, also initiate notebook mode, also plot and iplot. So what is difference between plot and iplot, that also I am described in my previous video, that is on Couplings and Plotly and Couplings. So please access those video to more clarification, the link is below in description. So the next cell, I have to initialize my notebook mode and connect it as a true. Then I have to import Couplings as a cf and press shift enter to execute my file, and I have to press shift enter to execute my cell. Then I have to say from import, I have to import go offline. So I have to import it by saying cf.go underscore offline and close parenthesis. After that, I have to import it my dataset. I am stored my particular dataset that I am downloading from Kaggle website is eDrive in pandas folder. To access this dataset from particular location, I have to import a OS library. So first of all, I have to import a OS library. After that, I have to simply say os.change directory, and I can set my change directory as eDrive and in pandas folder. And for reading the data, particular data set that is available in the CSV format, I have to import pandas library by simply saying import pandas as pip. So what is pandas library or what is numpy library? I am also created a videos on my channel and I am created a playlist on it. So please visit my channel, that is AI Era, and access those libraries. So execute this cell by simply pressing shift enter. After that, we have to import this data, that is worldometer underscore data dot csv, by simply saying df is equal to pd dot read underscore csv. And to visualize first 5 rows and its number of features that available in the dataset, I have to simply say df dot head, and in close parentheses I have to press and shift. So you can see over here, it shows a feature such as country and region, continent, particular country are belonging, from which continent, a population of particular country, total number of cases, a new cases, here in dataset new cases are not available, total deaths, new deaths that a particular day, total recovered, new recovered, active cases, serious and critical cases, total cases per million population, death per million population, total test, test per million population. After that, for getting more information of my dataset, I have to write a code such as df.info, and this command or this code will give me information about my dataset. So you can see over here, a df.info give me a total information from my dataset. A total 209 entries are available in my dataset, that is 209 rows are available in my dataset, which also it contains a 16 column. A column, the total 16 column name is mentioned below over here, and the total memory uses is 26.2 KB. After that, for create a geographical plot, I have to create a data and as my dictionary. So therefore, I have to store my all the variable in the variable called data. So in the variable called data, I have to create a dictionary, and in close parenthesis, I have to mention some hyperparameters such as type. So basically, we are working on a choropleth plot. Therefore, we have to select a type as a choropleth plot. Then in location, I have to mention a country name or a region. Then as a Z, I have to select a total cases or total number of cases are available in this particular region or this particular country. So I can select is selected Z is equal to total cases. Then for a color bar, I have to create another dictionary, that is a key is title and the class is total class. Then I have to select a color scale as a viridis, then reverse scale is equal to true, and location mode is equal to country names. So guys, if you don't get anything, don't switch off this video, just stay on it, because the output is a very impressive. To execute this cell, we have to press and shift enter. Then the next step, after creating a data as my variable, then I have to create my next variable as an layout, and in layout I have to create another dictionary, that is its content title of my particular graph or a particular image, that is title is COVID data. Then in geographical plot, therefore I have to select a geo, and in that geo I also create a dictionary, and it shows some hyperparameter such as show frame is equal to false and projection type is equal to natural earth, and I have to press and shift enter. After that, I have to import plotly.graph underscore objs as go, and after typing this command I have to press and shift enter. For getting a final result, I have to just pass this choromap3 variable from my iplot command. When I execute this a particular cell, it give me a output. So you can see over here guys, a total cases is 0. This bar shows a total cases. The maximum total cases is 5 million and minimum cases is 0. Here is Australia, here is my country India, which shows total COVID cases, that is cross about 2 million cases. Right now when I am creating this video, the India already crossed 30 million cases. After that, you can see over here Pakistan. So on geographical map, you can just point out or you can put your cursor on a graph, then it shows a particular country and its total positive cases present in that country. So we move towards our USA, beloved USA. So it shows positive cases is more than 5 million. And then here Brazil, 2.91 million. Here is my Russia. 870.89k total positive cases are present in this Russia, and the data set of China is I think removed from a worldometer data set, therefore cases of China is we not visualize over here, but you can see over here the country which can shows data or which to openly, so we can use this data and to visualize the total positive cases that are available in this country. So basically I can choose a natural earth, therefore it's look like the earth. You can rotate it, in any direction, left to right or left, right to left, or for you can zoom it. Here you can say India, Pakistan, Nepal, Bangladesh, Myanmar. You can zoom out. Here is my UK, Ireland, France. Just you have to point it out a particular country on a map, and you can get a total positive cases are present in that country. So for more clarification, I can just change as a total debt. I can change this Z parameter as a total death. To avoid typing, I just simply copy paste from it and paste it over here. I can kept my projection as a natural earth. Next, I have to to execute this particular cell, I have to simply press a shift enter and so around 160k people died in the world because of COVID-19, and here my India stand a green color because it's only 41,000 people are died because of COVID-19, and the America are presented in the purple color, which shows a world largest amount of people are died in the country. Around 162k people are died because of COVID-19. So guys, by using a such a wonderful graph, you can visualize a particular data set. You can see over here, you can move it from left to right, also you can zoom it and you can zoom out, and I think this is the best way to visualize any kind of data set using a geographical plot. So this is enough for today's video. If you like this video, please like this, share with your friends, and do subscribe my YouTube channel, that is AI Era, and don't forget to press and bell icon. And one more important note that if you feel any wrong or if you want to give any suggestion to me, then please comment it out in a comment section. Thank you one and all.